Hello everyone, we are having a conversation with Chinmay, who is a data analyst in Paramount Health Services, Mumbai, India. And he's going to talk about his transition from mechanical engineering to a data analyst. So Chinmay, thank you very much for your time today. Can you talk to us about your transition from mechanical engineering to data science field?
Okay, so first of all, I would like to thank you, Dhaval, for inviting me to your channel. And so let's start. Hi, I am Chinmay. I am a data analyst. If you ask me about my journey to become a data analyst, it is quite interesting. So basically, I am from a non-computer science or IT background. Yes, that seems little odd to know, but yes, I am a mechanical engineer, and for the last 4 years, I have been working with automotive. So let me describe my work environment there. Starting from the beginning, I come from a middle-class family in a city from Odisha. I was also an average student, though, and no one in my family had that exposure to technology. So after passing out from engineering in 2013, I joined automotive. So there, basically, my roles and responsibilities are a service manager who deals in management of maintenance and repairs, and repairs of small vehicles, managing manpower also, and part supply and technical training to professionals who want to come into automotive industry. However, in this period, I came across data science field, which is totally new to me. And I started inquiring more on it, and I find it's interesting as I already have business knowledge, which is the biggest advantage. And the things I really needed is programming skills and statistics. So I started inquiring more. I started learning from YouTube, other e-learning websites. Hopefully, in between that, I found Code Basics, which is my transition into a data science path. So I want to give full credit to Code Basics. It made me confident with my hands on machine learning. So accordingly, I enrolled in a data science professional specialization course in Coursera. So I started working on it, and it took almost 6 months and 6 to 12 months to enter my first step in data science, as I have previous job at the same. Then in October 2009, I completed that course and I joined a data analyst in a health insurance company that is Paramount Health Services. And currently I'm linked to Fairfax Asia Limited project.
What inspired you to join?
Okay, so firstly, I'm a technology lover, and as I was working in a customer-centric environment, so it always makes me feel curious to understand customer sentiments. And business starts from understanding of sentiments of a customer, and sentiments are nothing currently all about data. So I a deep intrigue towards technology and prior business knowledge is enough, and that thing really inspired me a lot. And my motivation always made a change to my career is Code Basics, and I never hesitate to tell to my friends that Code Basics best thing I like the most is its teaching quality, and everyone can understand in an easy way. That's the thing.
All right, cool. So what do you do 9 to 6 as a data analyst when you go for a job?
Okay, so when I am in office, I work on my office project generally. And currently I do Asia Pacific insurance data analysis and finding business problems, preparing recommendation using machine learning, and preparing business dashboards as well in Tableau. So, and when I'm on weekends, I love to learn. I usually read books in statistics, Python programming, and SQL, Tableau. I see YouTube videos, stats, math, how to deal with new challenges in data analysis. And I am currently working hard on my stats knowledge on different algorithms in machine learning. I also enrolled in a few Udemy courses, as these courses are very cheap and their contents are also very good. And that's the thing I do most of in my.
I see. All right. So that's pretty useful insight. And good that you mentioned Tableau. There are many BI tools nowadays like Power BI, Sisense, and having knowledge of at least one BI tool can help you in get a job as a data analyst. So that's a very good point. Now, what skills in general are needed to become a good data analyst?
So when I started learning, firstly, I learned a programming language, and that is Python. And I'll tell you why so. Let me give you one example. If I am a businessman and I want to do a business in US, so if I wish to communicate with a business manager in US, then I have to speak in English. So, or if I don't know English, then I might ask for a translator who can translate my language to English. And that translator or English is Python or R. And anyone, if you want to come into data science, that one thing you choose to communicate with data and to manipulate that and all that thing, that you have to choose one programming language.
Oh, wow. That's a very good way of saying it. Like English, how you use to communicate with human beings. If you want to communicate in terms of data, you need Python or R. So that's a very nice way of describing it.
Okay. So, and apart of that, the things I'll tell you what skills you need to learn, Python and R, that you can choose any one of them. Mm-hmm. And basic SQL to work with database that's stored in servers. And statistics is the most important thing currently. And machine learning, that actually in combinedly, statistics and machine learning are come in between. And one of the BI tool, that is Tableau or Power BI, as you said, that seasons and many more BI tools are coming right now. So these things you need to learn.
Good, good. Nice. All right. You quickly summarize the skills needed, which is basically Python, R, SQL, statistics, machine learning, and one of the BI tools. So the next question is, what kind of questions do they ask in data analyst interview? Because when you are transitioning from mechanical engineer background to data analyst, you must have appeared for certain interviews. So just talk about, like, what do they cover in the data analyst interview?
So in my interview, they ask about my past experience to know how much business knowledge I have. And apart of that, they give case studies involving business problems. Like if you are a marketing analyst and your company is going to launch a new product and in the market, and you have to collect what kind of data from a sample of people. And apart of that, they ask some basic SQL commands like left join, right join, inner join, full join, and how to connect to a database, different student truncate and drop. And if you have machine learning skills, they might ask you questions all from stats, and like what is the difference between variance and covariance, what is bias and variance trade-off, and difference between balanced and imbalanced data, what is L1 and L2 regularization, what is precision and recall. These things they might ask.
Okay, good. All right, so Chinmay's story here suggests that anyone from a different background, whether it's mechanical engineering, biomedical, you can become a data analyst. For data analysts, you don't need to have computer science background. In fact, if you have domain knowledge in other fields, such as biomedical, mechanical, engineering, whatever field you are in, the domain knowledge that you have acquired in that field is going to be very useful when you become data analyst. Because data analyst is not just about technology, it's about domain knowledge as well, understanding business, drawing insights, telling your data story. And domain knowledge is very, very important. So once you have the domain knowledge, you need all the technical skills, which Chinmay just mentioned, which is Python, R, SQL, BI tool, statistics, machine learning is needed, but you don't have to be really an expert, because there are some data analyst jobs where they don't require in-depth machine learning knowledge. But if you have that knowledge, of course, if you want to go step further and transition from data analyst to data scientist, that's when your machine learning knowledge can be useful, but it's not absolutely needed if you want to become a data analyst. All right, so thank you very much, Chinmay, for coming on the channel. I know you are one of the subscribers, and that's how we got in touch, right? Like I was doing this Call Me campaign, and we got connected, and that's when you told me your story that you are a mechanical engineer and became data analyst. And on the channel, many times I get these comments from people saying that they want to transition from mechanical engineering or whatever background to data analyst. And for that reason, I wanted to invite you on the channel so that people know that this is actually possible. And I'm going to provide a LinkedIn profile in the video description below. I guess you won't mind if someone has a question and they want to connect with you using your LinkedIn.
Yes, you might share.
All right, cool. Yeah, so if you guys have any question, LinkedIn profile, Chinmay's LinkedIn profile is in video description. You can connect to him. And if you want to get any insights, you know, especially if you're a mechanical engineer, then you have the best person to discuss any career related advice, etc. All right. Thank you very much.